So this is the Blazing Tigers MC, a group of vintage motorcycle role players who take GTA Cruise to the next level. They created the club back in August of 2015, and now have spanned across 9 different crews, with one of them ranking 4th in the world. They even have another crew that's ranked 11th on the leaderboards. These guys are the real deal. They roleplay as Vietnam veterans who have now joined a motorcycle club 20 years after the war. Following the theme of a classic biker club comes some of the most vintage bikes GTA has to offer. I met with the national president of the Blazing Tigers MC, who goes by the username Manhunt.
We are the roleplay motorcycle club. We are based on our Vietnam history. We use classic choppers like Daemon or Zombie or Bugger.
Bikes aren't the only thing this crew has to show off. They spent countless hours on emblem art, handbooks, outfits, midweek and weekend events, roleplay missions, training, MC wars, community work, and the list just keeps going on and on and on. With such a high rank on the leaderboards comes some real seriousness. This group is in the 1 percentile in all of Grand Theft Auto. They must follow values of respect and loyalty towards the group and its members. Following the rules may be hard for some, but getting in is even harder. When recruited, you will start as a hang around to get some experience with the guys. You won't be able to ride the bikes they ride or dress the way they dress, since you'll have to earn your bike and your outfit. As a hang around, you'll ride with them, do missions with them, get a feel of the group while they analyze you and your performance for about 10 days. If you are chosen to be promoted, you will rank up to a prospect, and you'll have to show your loyalty by staying at this rank for 30 days. This is designed to weed out any non-serious players and only accept the ones who have the heart to do what they do. As a prospect, you are able to unlock more clothing and bikes, but still not as much as a full patch member. I was invited to witness the promotion of a hangaround named Furries, who was about to become a prospect when I visited the group. Since the hangaround patch is different from the prospect one, the promotion was held outside of a clothing store, so he can put on his new patch inside and walk out of the clothing store one step further to becoming a full patch Blazing Tiger. After a quick word from his fellow MC members and leaders, and then after saluting both the left and right side of the crowd, it was time to ride. The ride along I had with the group was awesome. They made riding as a group look effortless. You would think communication would be a must in ride-alongs like this, and since they are such a well-ranked team, they would need to do a lot of talking, right? While that is correct, the Blazing Tigers MC is primarily Russian-speaking, with only a handful of English speakers. Even with these language barriers, the group continues to thrive, relying on various members to translate for them. The two members I witnessed translate were the national president himself, Manhunt, and another group member named Tori were awesome. The Blazing Tigers MC have many divisions, or chapters as they like to call them. They basically identify different areas of the map in which those players are assigned to. These include areas such as Vinewood, East Los Santos, Palito Bay, and the Grand Sonora Desert. Each member's chapter can be found just by looking at the bottom of his patch. Weaponry is a huge part of the Blazing Tigers MC. They tend to stick more towards a traditional style of combat by using weapons such as pistols, rifles, light machine guns, pump shotguns, and snipers. I asked the president of the BTMC Vinewood chapter, Pawnship, to explain.
We do not use rockets, RPGs, or miniguns. You'll never see us use those, especially in a war. We traditionally just stick to the marksman, the rifles, shotguns, and that's it.
They do not use hydras or tanks either. All they need to kick ass is a rifle with some ammo. They even go through tons of training together in custom maps built for practicing specific styles of combat. I was invited to watch as they battle to the death while building their skill and learning new tactics. The Blazing Tigers MC is by far the most diverse and coolest group I've ever encountered in Grand Theft Auto. If I had the time, I would without a doubt look into joining them. They keep such a nice, friendly environment about everything and welcome anyone who shows respect and loyalty their way. I really see a bright future in this group and know they can easily grow to even bigger heights. I just want to thank every single one of them for taking the time to be a part of this community showcase so I can showcase some of the best communities in GTA, and they have certainly set the bar really, really high. Thank you once again, Blazing Tigers, for the best experience I've had in GTA in a long time. And thank you for letting me feel like a Blazing Tiger for a day.
Generals gathered in their masses, just like witches at black masses. Evil minds that plot destruction, sorcerer of death's construction.